Hello students, welcome to the biology class. Today we are going to discuss the very important topic, that is your transcription. In our previous session we discussed about the replication. What is replication? In which the DNA can make its own copies. And transcription is a process, that is a synthesis of RNA from DNA. So the synthesis of RNA from DNA is known as transcription. What is the difference between RNA and DNA? DNA is double-stranded, RNA is single-stranded, and in DNA we are having a nitrogen bases, that is adenine, thymine, cytosine and guanine. Whereas in RNA, instead of thymine, we are having the uracil. So, wherever we are having, that is adenine is there, instead of thymine, that is uracil, then C and G. So, this difference is very important because when the synthesis of RNA takes place from the segment of DNA, then in the segment of DNA, wherever the T is present, that we have to write the U. Matlab, instead of A is opposite to U in the RNA. I will just show you what is going to be there. So that is your DNA, which is double helix. Fine. Here you are having A with T and G with C. Now, if from this particular double-stranded DNA, you want to have a single-stranded RNA, so A, G, C, T. So in RNA, we will have U, we will have C, we will have G and A. So A will go with U in RNA. This is your RNA strand and this is your DNA. So synthesis of RNA from DNA is known as transcription. As we know, DNA is double-stranded and RNA is single-stranded. So from the DNA double-stranded strand, only one will participate in the transcription as compared to the double-stranded. So how this transcription takes place? So suppose this is your DNA. So one segment of DNA, suppose this segment of DNA will help in the synthesis of RNA, and this segment is known as cistron. And when that gets unwinded, so you will have 3' to 5', and 5' to 3'. This is the segment of DNA known as cistron through which the synthesis of RNA will take place. But as we know that the new strand will form only with the polarity of 5' to 3'. As we have already discussed in our replications, that the new strand polarity is from 5' to 3'. So when the unwinding takes place, so which strand is known as a template, which is with 3' to 5'? Because against that strand, you will form the RNA. So opposite to that, that is from 5' to 3', is known as a coding strand, and 3' to 5' against which the RNA will synthesize, known as a template strand. Is it clear? What is template strand? That is from 3' to 5' against which the synthesis of single-stranded RNA will take place, because the polarity of the new strand is always from 5' to 3'. Opposite to that, that is 5' to 3', is known as a coding strand. Why it is a coding strand? Because suppose here you can see A, G, C, T. Opposite to that, you will have T, C. And similarly, in RNA, you will have U, C, G, same which is present in the coding strand. So with that, you will came to know that whatever is being coded on the RNA strand, that is a part of your RNA. Whatever is coded on the DNA, that is Cody's strand will have the nitrogen bases, the same nitrogen bases except thymine, the U is present in RNA, and that message will transfer for the protein synthesis. So in this particular transcription unit, that is cistron, we are having the promoter at 5' end of a coding strand. That is known as upstream because the new strand will form over there with 5' end. So promoter will be bind to the 5' end, that is the upstream. Then we have a structural genes, that is your ribonucleotides, depending upon the complementary of your DNA, like this way, A will go with the U, G will go with the C, C with G, A with the T, that is called as the ribonucleotides. And they will get polymerized with the help of very important enzyme. The name of that enzyme is your DNA dependent RNA polymerase, which helps in the polymerization of, so this enzyme helps in the polymerization of your ribonucleosides, which will form against that template strand of a DNA, and they are known as the structural genes. By the end, you will have a terminator where the synthesis is going to be terminated, synthesis is going to be stopped. That end is at the 3' end of a coding strand, that is downstream. So we are having a 3 units, that is known as a promoter unit. We have a structural gene unit, we are having a terminators. And this is known as your transcription unit, which consists, and from here, the transcription is going to be start. And here it is going to be terminate, that is known as your terminator site. So we are having the promoter, it is a binding site for the RNA polymerase. So what is promoter? It is the binding site of a RNA polymerase with the help of your primer, and the transcription begins. Structural genes, that is the code for the enzyme through which the long polymerization of the RNA chain takes place, and terminator, where the end of the region, that is the transcription, is going to be end. So promoter, where the transcription is going to be start. Structure gene is a polymerization of RNA, and here that is terminator where it is going to be end. So this is very important, go through this. In our next session we will discuss about the transcription in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Till then, thank you.